Rehoboam, the son of Solomon, is a fascinating character in the Bible who faced numerous challenges and made decisions that changed the course of Israel's history. His life is a clear example of how one person's choices, especially those of a leader, can influence and transform an entire nation. It also shows how the decisions of one generation, like those of Solomon, can impact subsequent generations, and how a father's mistakes can influence the fate of his son and an entire kingdom. Now, let's delve deeper into this story. Solomon, despite being known for his great wisdom granted by God, made significant mistakes. He imposed a heavy workload on his people and set high taxes. But perhaps his biggest mistake was marrying many foreign women who worshipped gods different from the God of Israel. These women influenced Solomon, and in his later years, he began to worship not only the God of Israel but other gods as well. Although Solomon erred, God, out of his love for David, did not take the kingdom away from him at that time. However, Solomon did face issues as a result of his decisions. God raised adversaries against him, like Hadad, Rezin, and Jeroboam. The latter, Jeroboam, was a competent and dedicated leader but disagreed with Solomon's oppressive policies. He contemplated leading a rebellion but, when threatened by Solomon, fled to Egypt. As you can see, the story of Rehoboam and Solomon teaches us much about the consequences of our decisions and how they can impact future generations. If you want to learn more about these captivating biblical accounts, don't forget to subscribe and activate notifications so you don't miss any details in our upcoming videos. Jeroboam had already been warned by a prophecy from the prophet Ahijah, revealing that Israel would be split into two kingdoms. Jeroboam would become the leader of the northern kingdom, consisting of 10 tribes, while Rehoboam, Solomon's son, would lead the southern kingdom, comprised only of the tribes of Judah and Benjamin. According to the Bible, in the first book of Kings chapter 12, after Solomon's death, Rehoboam went to the city of Shechem, where the people of Israel gathered to crown him king. Upon hearing this, Jeroboam, who had escaped to Egypt to avoid Solomon, returned. The Israeli authorities, aware of his return, met with him and jointly confronted Rehoboam. They asked him to relieve the heavy burdens and high taxes Solomon had established, promising loyalty if he complied. Pondering the matter, Rehoboam asked for 3 days to consider. He first consulted the elders who had advised his father. They advised him to be understanding and reduce the burdens to gain the people's loyalty. However, he also sought opinions from his young friends, who encouraged him to be even stricter than his father. In the end, Rehoboam chose to ignore the wise counsel of the elders and followed his friend's suggestion. Seeing the king would not meet their demands, the people of Israel rebelled, rejecting his leadership, leading to the kingdom's division. Rehoboam was left ruling only the southern kingdom. These events aligned with what God had previously revealed to Jeroboam through prophet Ahijah. In an attempt to reconcile, Rehoboam sent Adoniram, a former servant of Solomon, to speak with the people. But the situation had already changed, marking a new era for Israel. Tensions rose rapidly. Adoniram, Rehoboam's envoy, was met with fury by the people, who stoned him to death. Alarmed, Rehoboam quickly fled to Jerusalem. Most of Israel, on the other hand, chose Jeroboam as their king, leaving only the tribes of Judah and Benjamin loyal to Rehoboam and David's lineage. The book of 2 Chronicles 11 tells us more about this tumultuous time. Once in Jerusalem, Rehoboam summoned the forces of Judah and Benjamin. He gathered around 180,000 of his best warriors, ready to fight and reclaim Israel's kingdom. But a divine message changed their plans. Through the prophet Shemaiah, God ordered him not to confront the people of Israel. God explained that this division was his will. Heeding the divine voice, Rehoboam had his troops return without shedding blood. Determined to protect his kingdom, Rehoboam took measures to strengthen Judah's defenses. He built and fortified cities, equipped them with weapons and supplies, and appointed leaders. Additionally, the priests and Levites from the north, who couldn't serve the Lord due to Jeroboam, decided to support Rehoboam and brought resources to Jerusalem. Thanks to these efforts, Rehoboam's kingdom consolidated and strengthened within 3 years. Personally, Rehoboam had an active love life. He married Mahalat, his cousin, with whom he had 3 sons. Later, he married Maacah, Absalom's granddaughter, who gave him 4 sons. Rehoboam held a special affection for Maacah, more than any of his other wives or concubines. From all his unions, he had a total of 18 wives, 28 sons, and 60 daughters. Showing strategy, he appointed his son Abijah as the leader among his siblings, ensuring his succession. He also distributed his other sons across various territories in Judah and Benjamin, enhancing his presence throughout the region. Rehoboam's reign was full of ups and downs and lessons of humility and redemption. After firmly establishing himself in power, Rehoboam and his people made the mistake of straying from divine commands. Their unfaithfulness to God did not go unnoticed, and as a result, in the 5th year of his reign, Shishak, the mighty king of Egypt, marched against Jerusalem. With a formidable army, Shishak conquered several fortified cities of Judah and set his sights on Jerusalem. At this critical juncture, prophet Shemaiah intervened, conveying God's message to Rehoboam and the leaders of Judah. The divine word was clear: their abandonment of God had led to their desolation at the hands of Egypt. Hearing this, Rehoboam and Israel's leaders humbled themselves and acknowledged God's righteousness. Fortunately, their act of humility earned God's mercy. Shemaiah relayed that although they would suffer under Shishak, they wouldn't be entirely destroyed. However, they would be under the Egyptian yoke, serving Shishak to understand the difference between serving God and earthly rulers. As a result of this confrontation, Shishak plundered Jerusalem, taking treasures from the city, including the precious gold shield Solomon had made. Rehoboam, in an attempt to maintain morale and defense, replaced these shields with ones made of bronze. Rehoboam's reign was turbulent. Although he had the opportunity to rule for 17 years in Jerusalem, he did not seek God with a sincere heart, leading to perpetual war with Jeroboam. At the end of his life, he was buried in the city of David, leaving his son Abijah as his successor. Rehoboam's story is a reminder of God's merciful power and the possibility of restoration. Despite mistakes and challenges, God offered Rehoboam a second chance, showing his infinite patience and love. For those who followed this narration, we hope it has been enlightening. The Bible is a profound source of wisdom, guidance, and life lessons. Rehoboam's life illustrates how our decisions, for better or worse, have lasting effects on those around us. If we put God first and seek His counsel, we can avoid mistakes that can lead to generations of suffering. Thank you for joining us today. If you enjoyed this journey through biblical history, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more inspiring content. And as always, may God bless you.